in CAT 2020 quant paper, slot 1. This is part 4 of the slot 1. We will take 4 questions and try to solve. If you really want to crack the CAT paper, one way is to score really high in quant. And people normally who score really high overall are also the ones who score high in the quant section. So let's look at how to go about having the right method to solve. So among the 100 students, X1 students have birthdays in January, X2 on February and so on. Smallest value of X0, where X0 is maximum of these. Now the smallest value will be when all the values are equal. I mean, we know that sum of the values X1 plus X2 plus up to X12 is 100 because there are 100 students. And it will be minimum X0 when all are equal. It means 100 upon 12, which is 8.33. Now 8.33 is not possible that every value has to be 8.33 because they have to be integers because they indicate number of students, which means there will be students with 9 score, there will be students with 8 and 9. So in that case, the maximum value out here of X0, max of all these values, and the smallest possible value will be 9. So if you have a combination of 9 and 8, you can automatically make out that the value will be 9. The answer for this will be 9. The key is to understand the question and then try to solve. If you understand the question, it becomes easier to get the answer and faster too. Two persons walking beside a railway track, respective speeds of 2 and 4 kilometers per hour. So here, time is given 90 seconds and 100 seconds. So two cases, 2 kilometer wala and 4 kilometer. So ratio of the time, if you look at it, 90 and 100, which is 9:10, ratio of time. So ratio of the speed will be 10:9. If ratio of time is 9:10, ratio of speed is 10:9. Difference is 1, but we know the difference in the speed is 2 kilometers per hour because 1:2, 1:4. So difference is 2 kilometers per hour. So to make a difference 2, we have to multiply by 2. So this becomes 20 and this becomes 18. So if this is 20 kilometers per hour, right? So 20 kilometers per hour is net speed. That is speed of train minus that speed of man, which is 2 kilometers per hour, is 20, which means speed of train will become 22. So we know speed of train is 22 kilometers per hour. Now if you want to solve, the distance covered in both cases same, that means distance covered, let's say when you're crossing 2 kilometers per hour man, or distance covered when you're crossing the electric post, is same as length of train. So length of train is same as length of train. In the first case, length of train is you're traveling at 20 kilometers per hour for 90 seconds. Convert 90 seconds to hours, 3600. This should be equal to 22 kilometers per hour, then you calculate covering the post, into t seconds. Technically, you need not even write 3600 because both the sides, the units is same, seconds and kilometers per hour. You can directly solve. So you'll get t is equal to 20 into 90 upon 22, which is 10 upon 11. So you should know 1 upon 11 is 9.09%. So 9 upon 11 will be 81.81%. So which will give you 82 as the answer, because we have 900 upon 11, which will be 81.81 or 82 as the answer in this case. How many distinct positive integer value solution exist for the equation? How can you get one? You can get one by saying 1 raised to any value will give you 1. You can get 1 by any value raised to power of 0 will give you 1. You can get minus 1 raised to even value will give you 1. So 3 cases. Let's take the first case. In the first case, x square minus 7x plus 11 should be 1. Or x square minus 7x plus 10 equal to 1. From that you get roots as 2 and 5. So 2 values which satisfy. In the second case, we have x square minus 13x plus 42 equal to 0. You directly get roots as 6 and 7. Product of roots is 42, sum is 13, so 6 and 7. Third case, we require a base as x square minus 7x plus 11 equal to minus 1, or x square minus 7x plus 12 equal to 0. You get roots as 3 and 4. Now check, if I put 3 and 4, I will get the power as even, because if I put 3, right, I get odd even, which will be even. If I put 4, I get all three evens even. So power is even, so satisfies. So in that case, we have six values that satisfies. So automatically you have six solutions, A option. Okay, that will be the answer. So three cases, each case try to find the answers and you will get the answer. Region satisfying. So if you look at y is less than equal to 1, y is more than 0. So we have a region which is, if I look at axis, between y is 0 and y is 1. Now put this extreme case at y is 0. These are straight lines. At y is 0, what will this equation give? If I put x minus 0 is less than equal to 1, x less than equal to 1. So you get basically extreme cases 1 and minus 1. If you remove more. So at 0, you get the value as 1 or minus 1. Now put next case. At 1, what is the case? X minus 1 is less than equal to 1 or x is less than equal to 2. Extreme case will be x 2 minus 2. 2 and minus 2. So if you draw a straight line, because this equation resembles the straight lines, you get a trapezium. Area of trapezium is half into sum of parallel sides. That is, this is 4, this is 2, 4 plus 2 into height. Height is 1, because from 0 to 1, 1, you'll get 3. So automatically you get the area as 3, and that will be the answer for this. So just draw, figure out a diagram. It's just the area of trapezium which you can find out and get the answer. Right? I hope it's clear. Thank you.